Hello my dear students. So today the topic that is being covered is choppers. Now according to our syllabus, choppers, you have this curriculum content as 4.1, chapter number 4, define chopper. Okay, then draw the block diagram. Draw the basic power circuit of step down chopper, explain with waveforms. And the next one is draw the basic power circuit of a step up chopper, explain with waveforms. So only this much are the contents of this chapter number 4. And hitherto, you know, you have studied many power semiconductor devices. Power semiconductor devices starting from power diode, okay, and then its characteristics, then its layer diagram, okay, and application of power diode. After that, you studied about SCR layer diagram, its features, applications, and then importance of SCR, in fact, in power circuits. Then you studied about BJT, bipolar junction transistor, and afterwards you studied about power mass FET, in fact, power mass FET, its layer diagram, its application, okay. Then you studied about IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor, IGBT. So these are the power semiconductor devices that are exposed to in this curriculum. In fact, already you have studied. Then you studied about SCR turn on methods, different methods of turn on of SCR, and then commutation, different types of commutation and listing of commutation, etc. So after studying all these things, you know, the thing that you that comes to your mind is, these power semiconductor devices are used mostly as switches. They are all power semiconductor switches, semiconductor switches. And now you know different methods of turn on and as well as turn off. So commutation is also an important aspect of power semiconductor devices. So there are several methods of commutation. So leadingly you studied line commutation or natural commutation. So natural reversal of supply voltage is used to turn off or commutate the thyristor. So this is the technique that is studied in your curriculum, in fact, especially in this particular power electronics. If of course there are many other techniques, you know, so for commutation you studied only about natural commutation, that's all. So turning on is one important aspect, turning off is another important aspect. Okay, now after that you studied about SCR control circuits like R firing circuit, RC firing circuit, and UJT pulse trigger circuit, etc. Then in the last class, you have studied about controlled rectifiers. That is the first application, we can say. Controlled rectifiers. So rectifier, it converts AC to DC. Controlled rectifier, you can vary the output. That is the application of SCR, what you have seen in the last class. That is converter, in fact. Converter which converts AC to DC. Now this converter uses SCR and diodes. We have studied about full bridge converter, half bridge converter, dual converter, okay. So these converters convert AC input into DC output. And now you have this another application of SCR, you can say it is a chopper. You have to define chopper. Okay. Now, the moment you convert AC to DC, there should be some device to vary DC also. You have this chopper as a alternative to vary the output voltage of DC. Now, that is the basic approach for this chopper. Now, see, this chopper convert constant voltage DC input to a variable DC output. That means, from a fixed DC to a variable DC, so choppers are used. You can see the another application of your power semiconductor devices. Chopper is one application, converter is another application. Okay. So, from now onwards, you know, so all these things are applications of your power semiconductor devices. You see, when you have studied about control rectifiers, you are going to vary the voltage, output voltage slowly. Now, in this case of chopper, the chopper consists of power switches and diodes in a suitable configuration. This line is very important. That means they are connected in a suitable configuration. Now, what is the function of this power switch? The name itself is switch. The function is to just switch on and switch off. That's all. So, the importance of switching is it should switch on immediately, switch off immediately. So, that is the basic requirement of a switch. It is a semiconductor switch. So, this should never forget that these devices are ideal. As soon as you get the thyristor, it will switch on. As soon as you commute it, it will switch off. So, this is an ideal characteristic of a device. Now, chopper makes use of this concept of switching device. That means, power switches, we call it the word power switch. Now, the ideal switch and diodes, because your chopper consists of thyristors, okay, SCRs and diodes. We will come to that later, because the entire chopper circuit consists of these power switches and as well as diodes. So, when you build a circuit of a chopper, it should have some characteristics. The following are the ideal characteristics of a switch and a diode. You can see the number one over there. The switches have zero resistance in closed state and infinite resistance in open state. That means, switch is on means zero resistance, off means infinite resistance. Why this is important? Because these are power semiconductor devices. They have inherent resistance. Okay. Now, these are ideal condition in fact. So, ideally a switch should have a zero resistance in closed state and infinite resistance in open state. That means, it is open. The second part, this is very important that you have to observe. Switches can be closed, okay, and opened, in fact, can be closed and opened instantaneously. Instantaneously, this word, this is very important. Switches can be closed, that means they will react immediately, just like a switch, manual switch, what you operate. But these are semiconductor switches. So, switches, they are ideal in switching on and switching off. It is done instantaneously. And the third point, the ideal condition of this switch is, switches in closed state conduct current in one direction only and infinite resistance in reverse conduction. these points are, this is another important aspect of this switch. You know, these are switches. When I say switch, these are power semiconductor devices. And apart from that, you have diode in the circuit. Say, what is the characteristic of a diode? Diode have zero forward resistance. Whenever diode is conducting, it should not offer any resistance. And if it is reverse biased, it should have infinite reverse resistance. That means diode is also acting as a switch, in fact. But it is not a switch, it is a conducting device. Let us come to that point little later. Now, these are the ideal characteristics. Before you start studying about chopper, these things should be kept in mind, that these devices are ideal in their operation. Because a thing may come to your mind, or you may have some doubt in your mind, that whenever we draw VI characteristic of SCR, BJT or whatever the device, that what already I have studied, it shows initially zero. The current flowing through the diode or any power semiconductor device is in terms of microamperes. We say it won't conduct. It needs some triggering voltage. Okay, that is breakover voltage. Now, when there is a breakover voltage, then we say the device is conducting, and up to that point it is offering resistance. So these are ideal operating conditions. So whenever you study about choppers, keep in mind that this is totally ideal. A switch is a switch, okay. It won't offer any resistance when it is closed. It will offer infinite resistance when it is open, okay. Along with diode, you know, so the same thing is true with the diode. Say, what is a chopper then? So chopper is a variable DC circuit. It accepts fixed DC voltage and we get variable DC output. Why do we need variable DC? Yes, suppose you want to vary certain speed of a DC motor, or if you want to vary certain voltage applied to a circuit, so variable DC is required. Then what are the features of these choppers? So these choppers offer very smooth control. The controlling is just switching on, switching off, automatically in fact, by simply applying the gate pulse. You know, it is frequently subjected to commutation also, and subjected to triggering also. So these choppers offer smooth control. Compared to your manual operation, so if you want to vary the speed of a DC motor, you know, you are going to connect one rheostat. So there are two methods to vary the speed of a DC motor: armature control and field control. In case of armature control, you know, you are going to connect one series resistance, and then because of the variation of current, so your DC motor speed varies. It's a manual operation. This you might have conducted experiment in the laboratory also, but that won't offer a smooth control, since you have to vary the rheostat manually. This is important even with respect to field control. So field control gives very smooth control, we say, but due to the variation of your rheostat, it won't be smooth as expected. Okay. Now, because of that reason, you know, you can make use of these choppers, which gives very smooth control. Why it gives smooth control, we will come to that. As soon as we study about chopper, the technique adopted in chopper will definitely tell you how smooth the control is. It has high efficiency, obviously, because it is automatically operated. Fast response and regeneration. The response is very, very fast. Remember, when you are conducting experiment in a laboratory to vary the speed of a DC motor, you are using rheostat, and it takes its own time to vary the speed also. So these are the features of chopper. Why do we need chopper? Yes, these are the reasons. It's very smooth, high efficient, and fast response. This is very important. The variation in speed should be fast. Okay. Then chopper definition is like this. It's a high speed on off semiconductor switch. It connects and disconnects the load to the source at a high speed. It's quite obvious. It depends on how you trigger your SCR and how you commutate your SCR, because triggering commutation is also an important aspect here. Disconnecting. Connecting means triggering your SCR, means the switch is on. Disconnecting means commutating your thyristor. So these are the features of chopper. Then what are the control strategies? Control strategies means how to control the output, because the moment you want to vary the output voltage applied, so these are the strategies employed for varying the output voltage. Remember, for varying the duty cycle, the various control strategies are employed. Only two strategies are there. Number one is time ratio control, and number two is current limit control. Now, what is this time ratio control? You are going to vary the duty cycle of the applied frequency. Under this, you have a constant frequency system. Under time ratio control, I am speaking, you have to vary the duty cycle of the signal applied. Okay. So now this constant frequency system and variable frequency system. Constant frequency system, the other name is pulse width modulated scheme. Then the variable frequency system is frequency modulation scheme. So if you understand this concept, you know, you can easily understand about chopper. Of course, all these things are not in your syllabus. In your syllabus, you know, you have only about define chopper, that's all. Then straight away you have to explain step up chopper, step down chopper, but these are required to understand how this variation is done at the output. So this is, these information are required in fact to understand the basic concept of chopper. Otherwise, it becomes difficult to understand how this variation is taking place. Straight away, if you write a waveform, you know, you cannot understand what is happening in the circuit and how it is being achieved. Okay. So this is from the knowledge point of view, I am telling you the strategies employed for varying the duty cycle. Now, this time ratio control, you have two techniques: pulse width modulation and frequency modulation. Let us see one by one. So this is a PWM scheme, pulse width modulation. You can see the waveform over there. You can see T on time and T off time, and you can see this T marked like this. Say this is the on time and this is the off time. Okay. Now we know how SCR is being switched on and switched off. So this is the pulse width. So this is a total pulse width, total time period T of this cycle, T. T on and T off. Similarly, it is maintained T on, T off, T on, T off. Okay. Now we can see here the other waveform shown here. T on is more T of is maintained constant. Okay, T of. Now T on is more, T of is reduced. So total time period is constant. This is pulse width modulation. The width of the pulse is varied here. Okay, you can see the on period is more, off period is less. So carefully observe here, the time period is same. This is same for both the values. Okay, you see here, this is keeping time period same. The width of the pulse is varied, on time is varied. Okay, so that's why we say it is PWM scheme. So this is the load voltage, output voltage plotting. Okay, this is PWM scheme. Now the another scheme that is employed, keeping on time say this time period is T, keeping on time constant, you can vary off time, right? So this is a time period T on, T off, T on, T off. See, this on period is same, right? On period is same, off period is varied. So like this also you can vary the voltage at the output. Okay, say T off, T on. So T on is constant here, constant here, constant here. So the width of this T on time is constant, off time is more, on time is constant, off time is more, like this. So once again here also T on is same, off time is less. So T on, see, observe this waveform, this is very, very important. Keeping on time constant. Okay, similarly you can do off time constant. So this off time is kept constant, on time is varied. So on time is very less here, on time is very large here. Forget about this time period. Time period is more here, time period is less here. Okay, don't get confused with this PWM scheme. This is a strategy. You can do this varying the pulse width, keeping time period constant. Whereas here, time period is not constant, but you are varying the pulse width, keeping on time constant, keeping off time constant. Okay, students. So this is important. You have to observe how you can vary the output by varying different parameters like this. Okay. Now these are the control strategies pertaining to your PWM scheme, pulse width modulation scheme. Okay, the name itself says the width of the pulse is varied by switching on or switching off your thyristor. The very purpose of this chopper or utilization of your power semiconductor device in the circuit is, it is a switch. So we can definitely do this kind of operation, keeping time period constant and varying on time and off time. Keeping on time constant irrespective of the time period, you can vary the pulse. So this is pulse width modulation. The average output, you know, when you take up, it depends on this pulse. So this point you have to observe. So this is the strategy employed for getting the output variable voltage. Okay, next is your current limit ratio. Okay, frequency can be set by changing values of I maximum and I minimum. Okay, so you can see here the current. So now here only the current is taken into consideration. This is a current. Okay, so when it reaches maximum value, it will switch off. Then it freewheels until it reaches a minimum value. This is off time. The name itself says it is current limit control. In this current limit control, the current is reaching the peak, I maximum. When it reaches I maximum, it is going to zero, it is on state, we can say. when the current reaches maximum, when it is switched off, fine, it freewheels. So up to the minimum point, afterwards once again it will switch on. So this is a formation of pulse width, one pulse, one on time, one off time becomes one time period. So this is another control strategy employed for obtaining the variable output. Okay students, now this is the point where we start with. Now without what you have understood, you know, you have studied about, say, what is a chopper and why chopper is used, okay, and about the variation of output voltage using several techniques, that is PWM scheme and current limit control. Now this is the starting point of our syllabus, in fact. So this is only the introductory part to understand the chopper very correctly. Now you can see this diagram which is shown on your screen, a switch in the beginning. This is a switch. Now there are several devices, power semiconductor devices. It is an SCR, BJT, GTO. What is a GTO? Gate turn off thyristor. So thus, I think you have not studied about this GTO in this curriculum. We don't have this in our syllabus. So GTO is gate turn on thyristor. It is another power semiconductor device wherein you can apply gate pulse to trigger and apply gate pulse once again to switch off. It performs both switching on and commutation operation. So which is a costly device, in fact, GTOs. So this is a GTO. Okay, you have two arrow marks here, I think you cannot make out it, one to turn on, one to turn off. So this is another power semiconductor device. Another, you have PMOSFET. PMOSFET means power mass FET. Okay, once again it's a switch. Don't think any other way. Say these are all switches. Don't get into confusion. Nowhere, right? They are all switches. Now IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor. So all these things are represented as a symbol like a switch. So from now onwards, whatever the circuit you see there, you think that any of these devices, it is operated as a switch, that's it. Okay, don't get confusion. It is not a manual switch, it is a power semiconductor switch. Okay. Now you have some description here, VDC, that is average value of output voltage, IDC, average value of output load current, TON, time interval for which SCR conducts, time interval for which SCR is off, that is T off. The total time T is equal to T on plus T off, that is period of switching or chopping period. The frequency is given by 1 by T, frequency of chopper, switching or chopping frequency. So these are the terminologies normally used in this discussion. Okay. Now how do we get the average value of output, VDC, average value of the output device, whatever the chopper that you build, you know, VDC is equal to V into T on by T on plus T off. VDC is equal to V into T on by capital T. This is total time period taken. That is V into D, where D is a duty cycle. From this equation, you know, we come to know that the output voltage VDC is directly proportional to your duty cycle. So if you vary the duty cycle, definitely the output voltage will vary. So this is the concept of chopper. Okay, concept of chopper. So by varying the duty cycle, we can vary the output voltage. So this is the justification for this chopper. This equation is enough to understand how chopper is used to vary the output voltage. Now this is the operation, principle of operation. If you get the question, you know, so the same thing can be used for step down chopper. Let us say, what is the principle of operation? Say this is the switch, as I said, this is a semiconductor switch, and you have an inductor and a load connected to this. This is a freewheeling diode. So this semiconductor switch can be switched on based on the PWM technique or current ratio control. So this is a chopping frequency. The input voltage is DC. This is a supply voltage VS, plus and minus, and this is the chopper switch, which is subjected to switching on and commutation continuously. Switch on, switch off. The moment is this switch is on, the current flows through this and the circuit is established. The moment the switch is off, the current circulates in this freewheeling path. It circulates here. So this is the V naught output. So this is the principle of operation. Okay, you see here the output voltage waveforms, you know, this is a T on time and this is a T off time. Now the output current flows unidirectional. This is the time during which your switch is on. This is the time during which your switch is off. You can see the current. It is decreasing. Once again it is on, it is off, on, off. See, if you observe here, so the principle is this, the input voltage is this, let us say 100 volts. Now you are switching on and switching off continuously like this. You are chopping the voltage, input voltage. Now you could get the output like this. This is the average output voltage, this line. Otherwise it should have been VS, straight line like this. Without chopper, without this circuitry, VS, you know, this is VS, supply voltage, or V naught, whatever say. Now because of this chopping, you know, because of this chopping, this is the average voltage. The voltage is reduced. Okay. Now you observe this current. Current is unidirectional. It is increasing, decreasing. Of course, the average current, we are not bothered about this average current. Fine. Once again, it can take some line over here. So this is the average power, V naught into I naught. It is unidirectional. Okay. Now the output voltage is varied like this. By simply varying this duty cycle, T on and T off time, definitely you can vary the output voltage. So this is the principle of operation of chopper. If you get principle of operation of chopper, so you have to explain like this by taking this diagram and writing this output waveform. You explain what is the principle of operation. So how to switch on, how to switch off, etc. Okay. Now step down chopper. Of course, if you observe these two, you know, they are same. Step down chopper. Same thing you have to repeat. Right? Explain. Also, what is step down chopper? The input voltage is reduced at the output by chopping. So how to do that? You can see the type, this is also called as a type A chopper or step down chopper. Now the quadrantal diagram will tell you, so it will operate only in first quadrant. You have a chopping switch CH1, freewheeling diode, okay. From the waveforms, you know, you can easily observe the output voltage and output current are in one direction, and your load or a motor, whatever you connect, they operate in first quadrant. Voltage and current are both are positive here. So you can show this waveform like this. This is a type A chopper. You can see the output V naught is also positive, current is also positive. Of course, other variation of circuit you can write like this, both are same. In fact, the switch is written here and diode is here. Do not be panicked, because these are different circuits taken from the other textbooks. Okay. Now, this particular chopper is a step down chopper, because input voltage is reduced at the output. Okay. Now, this operates in first quadrant, motoring operation, we can say. See, this is the waveform, waveforms of step down chopper. You see here T on, T off, T on, T off, and the current, this is chopping period and this is the output current. S1 is on, D1 is on. What is D1? D1 is here, S1 and D1. So this circuit or waveform will clearly tell you what is happening in the circuit. During the chopping period, on period, this is on, okay. This part is a freewheeling part, okay. The moment you close the switch, you know, so current flows through this to the load, because this diode is reverse biased when the input source is high. The moment you open this, the kinetic energy stored here needs a freewheeling path. Okay. So like this. So this is on period, freewheeling period, on period, freewheeling period. So you have to write down the chopper, step down chopper like this. You have to write this diagram, you have to write this quadrant diagram, and then this waveform. Okay. So this is step down chopper. So you have to write this circuit diagram, explain what happens. So what is the technique adopted? So you are going to close the switch, open the switch. So this is frequently done here, right? The output voltage varies, the input voltage is chopped frequently based on the time period, PWM, pulse width modulation technique. The average voltage available at the output reduces, that is why it is a step down chopper. Then of course, what is the load? You can connect a DC motor here. Okay. So if you want to control the speed of a DC motor, definitely you can do this, achieve this by suitably varying the switch, PWM. Pulse width modulation. You can expect smooth speed variation here. Both voltage and current are in positive direction. Okay. Now the input voltage is varied, so your speed will vary. That's why it is a step down chopper. You can say it's a DC transformer, right? Because transformer, in case of AC transformer, the moment you say transformer, it is AC only, there is no DC transformer. Transformer will step down, step up, 1 to 1 ratio, like this you have classification of transformers. So in case of DC, you know, so this is a step down chopper, and the next one I am going to deal with is step up chopper. So definitely you can say it is like, it is working like a transformer. Now how this step up chopper works, you can see this voltage source connected to load, okay, and see the position of the switch thyristor, it is shifted, okay. The moment you close this switch, what happens? This is the circuit. The moment you open this switch, this is the circuit, right? So now, a very important observation that you have to make here is, what is a step up chopper? Your input voltage is this and your output voltage is this. I mean to say, this voltage should increase compared to this one, then only we can say it is step up. Suppose this voltage is say 100 volts, I should get 140 volts, 120 volts, yes, it is step up. But how to do this, how this circuit supports the stepping up of voltage available at the output? This inductor, which is connected in series, is important. Okay. This inductor is important. Remember, the moment you close this switch, the inductor stores energy, half L square. The energy is stored in the inductor. Okay. See, carefully observe these points. This is very important point to understand. So now this inductor is storing energy the moment you close the switch. When you commutate or open the switch, what happens? This source along with this energy will forward bias this diode and load will receive the circuit, receive the supply. Is it so? But because of this reason, this load will supply back the voltage. Okay. So this is a step up chopper. So when the diode is on, it is like this. Then I have shown RLE load. What is RLE load? In fact, this I have discussed in the previous class. Say E is a back EMF of a motor. We can say this is the voltage. V is equal to L di by D naught R into I naught plus E. You can see the wave, the equation given here. L into di by D naught, there is a voltage across the inductor. I into R naught, okay, this current flowing through this resistance, and this EMF E. See the polarities. Okay. Now this is the voltage equation of this step up chopper. Okay, so this will increase. The next is, during the interval chopper is on, voltage equation is given by this one. Okay, chopper is on, the voltage equation is given by this one. Okay. Now V naught is equal to V plus L into di by dt. Now V naught is greater than V. This is the required condition for step up operation. Don't forget these things, because the moment this inductor is storing energy, this will add up with the load voltage, source voltage. Okay. Now V naught, the moment we say this one, that is supply voltage is greater than supply voltage is less than output voltage, it is step up operation. Okay. So this is the justification. Okay. Now this concept is used in regenerative braking. So this is the waveform, output voltage waveforms. You see the current is on and off like this, T on, T off, T on, T off, mean current ratio control, you know, minimum, maximum, minimum, maximum. This output is on, V naught is on, current, output current is like this. Okay. So these are the voltage and current waveforms. You can see the output, input voltage V is shown straight line DC, ideal without ripples, and this is the source current, minimum to maximum, maximum to minimum. So this is the T on period, T off period, like this. Okay. Now this type B chopper, if you observe, the voltage is positive, whereas current reverses. How current reverses? Okay, the moment you close the switch, the current should flow like this. Okay, the voltage is same, voltage polarity is same. It is operating in second quadrant. Earlier step down chopper operated in first quadrant, whereas here it is operating in second quadrant. Okay, that's why it is plotted in second quadrant, V naught and I naught. It is also called as a type B chopper. You can see here the waveforms of the step up chopper. The output voltage, T on time, V in, T on and T off, these are the pulses applied, and this is the current, variation of current like this. So the devices which are on, S2 is on, D2 on, S2 on, D2 on, S2 on, S2 is a switch shown here, this is a switch, S2 on, D2. See this diagram, you know, it clearly shows which device is conducting. S2 is conducting, D2 is conducting, S2 conducting, D2 conducting, like this. Of course, you can also write this one, off on, chopper conducts, D conducts, chopper conducts, D conducts, like this. Okay. Now this regenerative braking of DC motor using this chopper, EA is a source voltage, you can say, V naught is a load voltage. Now this becomes a load voltage now. Now what is regenerative braking? Of course, this concept you will learn in industrial drives and control, especially in traction work. For traction application, this regenerative braking principle is used because it works at a very high load. It is a series motor. The series motor is shown over there in the screen. On the screen you can see here, right? Now V naught is a load voltage, see. So what is regenerative braking? This is a motor, right? The motor should start working as a generator, then that is called as a regeneration braking. That means the back EMF should be greater than the supply EMF, then only we can say it is regenerative mode. This is the industrial application of this chopper. Okay. Now your generator, your motor starts working as a generator because of this voltage. Okay. So these two voltages, when this is more, definitely it has to forward bias this diode and then it receives the supply. So this is the regenerative braking. What is braking? It is braking, braking. Braking is a concept to stop the motor. To stop the motor, because in case of starting a motor, it runs at a very high speed and then it slows down, it takes a long time to stop. But using this concept, making the motor to work as a generator, it tries to rotate or it tries to build up reverse torque. So this production of reverse torque brings the motor to a halt at an early stage. So that is the concept of reverse current braking. You can see load voltage variation with respect to duty cycle. Here you see the variation of alpha duty cycle and then the voltage, output voltage graph. See, it shows infinity, you know. So this is a clear indication that you can always vary the duty cycle and obtain higher output voltages compared to input voltage. Vs is a source voltage. V naught is increasing here twice, four times, etc. It is infinity. Okay. Now, chopper commutation. You have forced commutation, usually employed, voltage as well as current commutation, and load commutation. Load commutation means RLE devices are used to commutate. Commutation means you have to apply reverse voltage. That's it. Okay. Usually employed commutation techniques are forced and load commutation techniques. Of course, these things are not in your syllabus. I am just showing you the different configurations of chopper, that is class A, class B chopper combination. It becomes like this. It gives you first as well as second quadrant operation. It is a combination of type A, type B chopper. So RLA, once again, it is a motor, do not forget. Then you have a class D chopper. This combination will give you first quadrant as well as fourth quadrant operation. Okay. Of course, these are the waveforms pertaining to this class C and class D amplifiers. So chopper, sorry, class E chopper. This is a special chopper which gives you all four quadrant operation. See here, all conduction sequences are given here, CH1 to CH4. Okay, so class E chopper will give you all four quadrant operation if required, based on the industrial application. Okay, then coming to application of choppers, usually it is the list you get like this: application of chopper, or write the application of chopper, list the application of choppers. It is used in trolley cars, marine hoists, forklift trucks, mine haulers, modern automobiles for speed controlling and braking. Modern automobiles. Okay. So this is about application of chopper. And in this lecture, you know, so you have to take up only definition of chopper, then principle of operation of chopper, and what is meant by step up chopper, and what is meant by step down chopper. So these things are there in your syllabus, and you have to write down the output voltage waveform, current waveforms. Okay, only this much are there in your syllabus curriculum content. Okay, so the other information, it is only for your sake of knowledge. Okay, so that you can always utilize those things to understand this chopper. So basically, you know, it is another application of your semiconductor device. You can give one more list to your power semiconductor devices. Usually you get this question, you know, in say application of BJT, application of MOSFET, application of SCR, like this. So this is another common application of chopper. Chopper is common application of all your power semiconductor devices. So in the beginning itself, I showed you the switch is represented as SCR, BJT, PMOSFET, GTO, IGBT. So for application of these power semiconductor devices, you can add this one, chopper. Okay, and this application of chopper itself as a unit, as a circuit, you know, you can, it is used in these modern application like this. So all these things, once again, they use motors for their control. And once again, the DC is used, DC motors are used here, which are efficient in all these applications. Now the application part is like this. Okay, so that is about chopper. Okay, now to conclude, you know, so this chopper is like this, and all circuits wherever you study, you know, it is represented as a switch, nothing else. And along with the inductor, you know, you can change the shape or working of a particular circuit. You have to practice writing this diagram and position of the switch, inductor and diode. They are very important. Okay, so you have to practice these diagrams at home. And very basic thing you have to understand that is switching on your switch or your thyristor, and then about the energy stored in the inductor. Okay, so summing up this voltage, the voltage across inductor, whether is additive or subtractive, okay, this will decide whether you are stepping up or stepping down. And one more concept is the quadrantal operation of these thyristors or these choppers. This is a very important application, in fact. So we have shown first quadrant operation, which is totally motoring operation. Then third quadrant operation is reverse motoring operation. Sometimes it is required you have to reverse the direction of rotation of your motor. And then third quadrant operation, that is regenerative operation, braking operation. So extensively this braking is employed, because you have to stop the motor at an early stage with less loss. So if you use a mechanical brake, you know, mechanical losses are more, and it is difficult to bring the motor to rest at an early stage. This is a smooth control. That's why the very beginning, you know, you said it gives you a very smooth control. That is an important application of stopping a motor and starting a motor. That's why these choppers, they offer variable voltage DC. So wherever this application creeps in, you can always think of this building up chopper and operate the motor in any of the quadrant as desired. And of course the circuits looks very simple here, but the actual circuit is very complex. If you look at the actual circuit, it is very complex, because we do not write any commutation circuits, right. If you have external commutation or load commutation, it is once again difficult. Of course, to understand the concept, this is enough. Okay. Now this is about chapter number 4, and this completes chapter 4 on choppers. Okay. Thank you, and study about these choppers. And the probable questions are like this, very simple. Define chopper, explain the principle of operation of chopper, and then explain step down chopper, and we write the waveforms, pertaining waveforms for that, and explain step up chopper on its configuration along with the waveforms. So these are the expected questions from this chapter. Okay, thank you.